Hey everyone, welcome back to new video. And in this video, we're gonna set up Koin Dependency Injection framework into our KMP project. So without wasting any time, let's get started with our project. First, go to the description box where you can find my initial project GitHub repository link. Download the project and open up into your Android Studio. So your project will look something like this. Once you change your mode from Android to project, open up your Koin DI project. And in this, we will begin with our shared module. In the share module, open up your build.gradle file, and in this I have already given you all the dependencies that you might require in order to set up Koin dependency injection in your project. So for the common main, we are having Koin dependency, and also I have added few lifecycle component for Jetpack Compose dependencies. And in our Android main, I have added our Koin that is required for Android and also its core dependency. So let's begin with our project. So here I'm gonna create two things. I'm gonna create a use case and view model. I want to inject my view model in both platforms. So let's begin with our project. So open up your source folder, and in this we are having three modules: Android main, common main, and iOS main. Let's begin with our common main. So in this I'm gonna create directory, and the directory name is use cases. And also I'm gonna create one more directory for our view models. In our use case, I'm gonna create a class. This class name would be fake use case. In this we are having operator function invoke that would return me you have successfully set up Koin DI. Now it's time to create our view model. So in our view model directory, I'm gonna create a fake view model. This is a class, and this class will extend view model so that we have a view model scope or all the properties of our view model. Now in this I want to inject my fake use case. So in its constructor, I'm gonna create a variable, and the variable name is fake use case. We are having a function over here which says fetch message. I will use fake use case and invoke its function. Alright, so we are pretty much done with our very basic initial setup. Now it's time to begin with our Koin dependency injection. So for that, I'm having a directory over here, and the directory name is Koin. In this, I'm gonna create my share module that we want to share in both platforms. So for that, I'm having a file, and the file name is shared module. In this, I'm gonna create a variable naming share module. With the help of module, I'm gonna create a module, Koin module basically. So in this, I'm using factory. So if you want to create an object again and again when you inject any place, on that case, you can use factory. So we are having here fake use case. So this will now injectable once you add this share module in your Koin dependency injection framework. Alright, so now it's time to provide view model. So now view model is something which is platform specific. In Android, we are having different way of creating it. In iOS, we are having different way of creating it. So for that, I'm gonna create a file, and the file name is view model module. This is a file, and in this file, I'm gonna create an expect function get view models. Module. This will return me module. So expect keyword is used when you want to return this function implementation in both platform separately. So now it's time to implement this function one by one in our both platforms. So for Android main, I'm gonna create here a file, and the file name is view model module. In this, I'm gonna paste the function name and its return type. So simply copy this stuff and come back to your Android main view model module, paste it over here, and make sure to use actual in front of your function. Just like we use expect, we have to tell our compiler that implementation will be given over here. So for that we use actual keyword. So here we are having a module, and in this module I'm gonna use a view model function. So if you want to get a view model, on that case in Koin dependency injection framework, you have to use view model function over here. Now I'm gonna use here fake view model and simply inject my dependency, which is fake use case. Okay, so we have successfully implemented get view models module in Android. Now it's time to set up our Android environment for Koin dependency injection. So for that, first I'm gonna create here base application. This class will extend application, and in its lifecycle on create, I'm gonna register my Koin. So for that we are having start Koin, and also I'm gonna register my Android context. So this at the rate base application. Now here I'm gonna add all of my modules. So for that we are having modules function. First I want to add my shared module, and also I wanna add my get view models module. Alright, so we are done with our base application. Now it's time to register this application into my manifest. So for that, open up your Compose app, source, Android main, and here we are having our Android manifest. So open this thing up. and simply add your base application. Okay, so now we are done with our Android setup. Now it's time to use this stuff in our iOS application. So for that, first thing first, copy this thing. Open up your iOS main module, and here I'm gonna create a file, and the file name is view model module. This is a file, and in this file I'm gonna simply paste the function that we have copied from Android directory or Android main module. We can't access here view model, so how can we provide view model so that we can use that thing in iOS? So for that I'm gonna create here a private while view model modules, and here I'm gonna use view model single fake view model. We have to inject our fake use case in here. So for that, I'm gonna use here get. Now remove this module, and instead of this module, you can view models module. One more thing, if you want to implement this shared function, which is get view model module, on that case, you have to follow the package structure too. So for that here, I'm gonna create a directory, and the directory name is Koin. And in this Koin, I'm gonna put my view model module in iOS main. Now you can see we don't have any warning over here. Similarly for the Android, I'm gonna create here package, and the package name is Koin. In this Koin, I'm gonna put my view model module. All right, so you can see the error is gone. Now go back to your iOS main one more time, and here if you want to inject your view model into Swift UI, on that case we have to get an object, and this object name would be provide view model, and this will extend our Koin component, and in this we are having a function. So first function is get fake view model, and this will give me fake view model, and here I'm gonna use get. Now it's time to set up Koin dependency injection framework into my iOS application. So for that, in our common main, I'm gonna create a file, and the file name is helper, and in this file I'm having a function init Koin. In this we are having an start Koin, and by using this you can actually set up your iOS environment so that they can use Koin dependency injection framework. Now it's time to register all of our modules. So for the modules, I'm having a function modules. In this I'm gonna attach my share module plus my get view model. Okay, so now it's time to use init Koin function into my iOS app. So for that, open up your iOS application. From here, in this we are having iOS app one more time. Open up your iOS Swift. I'm gonna add my helper file. So for that, we are having here helper kt.do init Koin. Make sure to import your share module over here. And yeah, we are pretty much done with our setup for Android and iOS. Now I'm gonna use my view model in Android. So for that, go to your Compose app, open up your Android main module, and in this we are having Kotlin directory. So open this thing up, and in this we are having application. So here in my application, I'm gonna inject my fake, and I'm gonna initialize this thing with Koin view model. Koin view model is not accessible over here because we don't have dependencies for that. So first I'm gonna add those dependency in my buildgradle file. So go to your shared module buildgradle file, copy these dependencies, come back to your project in our compose app module, and here I'm gonna add these dependencies. And also we have to add this dependency to Koin Android X compose. So for that, go to your compose app buildgradle file, duplicate this thing, and we are having here Koin Android X dot compose. Now sync your project. Go to your app file, and here just check whether it is available or not. Yes, it is there. So Koin Mobile module. Now in place of greeting dot greet, I'm gonna replace this thing with fake view model dot fetch message. And now it's time to execute our application. So I'm gonna execute this thing in Android first. So now when I click this button, you can see you have successfully set up Koin dependency injection. That means we have successfully injected view model into my composable. Now it's time to use Koin DI into my iOS application. So for that, first we have to open our project in Xcode. So let me minimize this thing, and I'm gonna use Xcode. Open existing project. Go to downloads, and we are having Koin DI and our iOS app. So open this thing up. So first I'm gonna execute my app to check whether everything set up properly or not. All right, so our app is executing. That means everything that we have done for Koin dependency injection framework setup in iOS, it's working. So click on this click me button, and it will open up this beautiful icon. Now it's time to use Koin DI. So for that, I'm gonna create a new file. This is nothing but a Swift file, and I'm gonna call this fake view model wrapper. Okay, so this is nothing but a class, and the class name is fake view model wrapper. And in this, I'm going to create a variable, and the variable name is view model. Type would be fake view model. In this, we are having a init block, and in this init block, I'm going to initialize my view model. So for that, I'm going to use here provide view model object that we have created in our iOS main package. So let me show you. So here you can see we are having provide view model. So I'm going to copy this stuff, go back to our Xcode and use it. Shared, and in this we are having a function get fake view model. So I'm gonna use it. Make sure to import your shared module. Extend your fake view model wrapper with observable object. Go back to your content view, and in this content view I'm gonna use my view model. In this I'm gonna create an observable object, and the observable object name would be private var fake view model wrapper. Type would be fake view model wrapper, and I'm gonna initialize this thing with fake view model wrapper. All right, so now it's time to use it. So here in place of text greeting, I'm gonna remove this greeting.greet. Instead of this, I'm gonna use my fake view model wrapper. We are having view model in it, and in this view model we are having fetch message function. So I'm gonna use it. Now execute this application. All right, so our app is executing. Now when I click this button, you can see Swift UI, you have successfully set up Koin Dependency Injection. That means we have successfully injected our view model in iOS platform. So yeah, that's it for this video. I hope you like this video. It's a very simple video to set up Koin Dependency Injection framework in our KMP project. We will meet in our next video where we will discuss something new about KMP. Till that, goodbye.